We will start our problem with isosceles triangle with the base of 6 and the legs of 5. Then inside this triangle we will inscribe the square so that the one side of our square is touching the left leg of the isosceles triangle and the other two vertices are touching the right leg and the base of the triangle just as shown in the sketch. The question is, can we somehow calculate the area of this red square? If you want to answer this question for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So I'm going to offer you two different geometry methods to solve this problem. So let's start with the method number one. We're going to start this method by labeling all the vertices of our triangle as A, B, and C. Then we will pull the height from the apex at the point C and we will label its intersection with the base as D. Here I just want you to notice the fact that this height is not located at the bottom vertex of the square. Alright, so now let's calculate this height. We're going to do that by taking a look at the triangle ADC. We know that the height of the isosceles triangle is dividing the base into two identical segments, so since AB is equal to 6, this means that AD must be equal to 3. And you can notice that this triangle is Pythagoras' right triangle with the hypotenuse of 5 and the legs of 3 and 4. Of course, if you are a newcomer to mathematics, you can always use the Pythagorean theorem to try to find this height. And I will leave you complete solution on the right if you want to pause the video and check it out. Okay, so now let's continue by taking a look at our isosceles triangle ABC. We will now pull the height from the vertex B up until the left leg, and we will label this intersection as E. Now, we know that the area of the triangle is equal to the product of the base and height divided with 2, so in our case this is AB times DC over 2. But we can also get the area as the product of the leg AC and the height EB. So we are just going to substitute the values from our sketch, then we're going to simplify everything, and finally get that 24 is equal to 5 times EB, which means that the height EB is equal to 24 over 5. Now let's label all the vertices of our square as P, Q, M, and N. Then we will label the intersection between the lines EB and QM as O, and finally we will label the sides of our square as S. Now we will use one really interesting property of the angles in parallel lines, which states that if we have two parallel lines and we pull another line through those lines, which is actually called a transversal, then we can say that each pair of corresponding angles on the same side of the intersecting transversal are equal to each other. So, if you take a look at the angle at the point A and the angle at the point Q, you can notice that those two angles have the same properties, because the lines AN and QM are parallel to each other, since the line PN and QM are actually the sides of the square, and in this case the line AB will represent the transversal line. So those two angles must be congruent. So with this in mind, we will take a look at the triangle ABC, and we can isolate it. Then we can take a look at the triangle QBM and we can isolate this one as well. You can notice that both of those triangles share the common angle at the point B. So, since those two triangles have two congruent angles, this means that their third angle must be congruent as well. So, those two triangles must be similar triangles. And we can use the rule of similarity, which states that the relation between their legs must be equal to the relation between their heights. So now let's have a look at the line OB. Since we know that the line EO is equal to S, we can calculate the length of the line OB as the difference between the height EB and the line EO. So, since we already have the height EB, we're just going to substitute those values. Then, let's notice that we already have the length of the line AC, which is equal to 5, and we know that the line QM is equal to the side of the square, so we can label it as S. Then, we're just going to substitute all those values back into our previous equation. And by doing so, we will get the following. Now, we can cross-multiply this, and then we can simplify by multiplying both sides with 5 to lose the fraction, and we will get that 120 is equal to 49s, which means that the side of our square is equal to 120 over 49. Now, it's pretty easy to find the area of the square, since the area is equal to the side squared. We're just going to substitute the value for our side, and by putting everything to the square, we will get that this is equal to 14,400 over 2,401, which we can really nicely approximate to 6 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the second method, which is also a geometry method, but we're going to use some facts from our previous method. First, we're going to label the vertices of our triangle, again, as A, B, and C. Then we're going to label the vertices of our square as P, Q, M, N, and we're going to use the fact from the previous method that the triangle ABC is similar to the triangle QBM. We already proven this. So, since triangle ABC has the sides of 5, 5, and 6, this means that the triangle QBM will have the sides of 5K, 5K, and 6K, where K stands for factor of similarity. Now, we can also label the side of our square as S, and then we will take a look at the side QM. This side has the length of S, but it also has the length of 5k. So this means that S is equal to 5k, which means that the factor of similarity is equal to S over 5. With this in mind, we can calculate the side QB. We can just substitute the value of k, and we will get that this side is equal to 6s over 5. Now, let's try to find the line AQ. We can get the length of this line as the difference between the base AB and the segment QB. So, if we substitute our values, and then work through this, we will get that AQ is equal to 30 minus 6s over 5. Then, we're going to pull the height of our triangle ABC from the apex C, and we're going to label the intersection as D. And we know that this height is equal to 4 since we already calculated it in the previous method, so I'm not going to repeat those calculations again. Then, we will also notice that the points D and Q are not coincident. So now let's first have a look at the right triangle ADC, and we will notice the angle at the point A. Now we will isolate this triangle. Then we will notice another right triangle APQ, and you can see that this triangle actually shares the same angle at the point A. And again, since two angles of those two triangles are congruent, this means that those two triangles are actually similar triangles. So, we can use the rule of similarity. We can say that the relation between their hypotenuse and leg must be the same. So now, we're just going to solve this equation to get S. We are first going to cross-multiply it and get the following. Then, we're going to lose the fraction by multiplying everything with 5, and we will get the following. From here, we will get that 49s is equal to 120, which means that the side of our square is equal to 120 over 49. Now, Again, we can easily find the area as side squared. We're just going to substitute our side and we're going to get the same result as before, which is going to approximate to 6 squared units. And again, we have our solution. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this interesting problem. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel if you already haven't. It means a lot. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section below, as you always do. And until next time, as always, see you all and take care.